This is Officer Heath Mitchell of the Cartersville Police Department in Georgia. He may look like any other American cop, but in fact, he's a cop with a difference. He's on a mission from God.
Do you make many converts while you're on the job?
Yes, quite a few. Quite a few.
Officer Mitchell is a member of Cops for Christ, an organization of evangelical police officers who combine their law enforcement duties with a mission to preach the gospel.
I mean, what y'all stopped me for? There's no reason for y'all to stop me like this.
10-14, peeping Tom.
10-14?
I got you last time for it.
I'm tell you the truth, I ain't no peeping Tom. I'm not no peeping Tom.
Cops for Christ's headquarters are here in Long Island, New York.
You have a right to consult your Bible before witnessing God's word, now or in the future. Do you understand? If you cannot afford a Bible, one will be provided for you without cost. Do you understand?
Officer Joe Scarano founded Cops for Christ after he was blessed with a vision at a New York airport.
Tell me how you saw
the vision. I saw it was in the sky as I was working at Kennedy Airport. I looked up in the heavens.
Which terminal?
It was not a terminal. It was just on patrol.
Oh, okay.
I was near the International Arrivals Building area.
Yeah.
I was looking up and I was looking at the planes flying up, and I saw the vision of the emblem of Cops for Christ.
We saw this emblem here.
This emblem here. We are ordained by God. God sets laws and governing positions around, not only as a Christian officer, but any police officer.
Is ordained by God?
Ordained by God, it says in Romans 13.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
Do Christians make better cops, do you think?
Well,
no question.
No question about it.
God is love.
God is love.
And you love one another. And we can love the worst sort of criminal and yet take effective action to bring him into custody.
Shoot him if necessary.
If absolutely. Kill him if you have to. But you do it in love. There's a difference.
We want to meet some cops for Christ. Who do you suggest we go meet?
Well, we have 75 chapters, but I suggest going to see Bob Earler at Tucson, Arizona.
I found Bob Earler at Cactus Community Church. Earler is Cops for Christ's international chaplain. He's no longer a cop himself. He left the force in the late 60s when he was convicted of second-degree murder.
The nickname was the Catch Me Killer.
Why?
Well, when I called the police department, I said, please catch me, because I just killed three people. I said, catch me before I kill again.
You actually said that?
I actually said that, yeah. And I call it demon possession today, but at the time I thought I was totally insane.
What does the future hold for Cops for Christ, do you think? Is it going to grow?
It's grown with leaps and bounds, and I'm very, very thankful that they invited me to be their international police chaplain. I'm certainly not worthy of it. I haven't earned anything, and truthfully, I deserve the death penalty. But God showed me mercy, Larry.
Earl is such a dedicated cop for Christ, he'll try to convert anybody.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Did you mean it?
I tried to mean it.
Okay. In fact, Cops for Christ have any number of ways to reach out to the American public. There are radio shows.
Because God promised us, one day, we all shall meet in the air. Again, this is Dennis Frazier, standing in for the Cops for Christ. Signing off. Have a good day.
Revivals in malls.
Good all the time.
Even a small motorized Jeep that's a big hit with the kids. There is one teeny problem with all of this. The United States Constitution. The First Amendment to the Constitution clearly states that government and religion should remain separate. A fact that seems to be lost on Cops for Christ.
Which is more important, police regulations or the Bible?
Oh, the Bible, no question about it. And when the police regulations differ with the Bible, then I don't obey the police regulations anymore.
Really?
That's right.
Would you like to see all the cops in the U.S. being Cops for Christ?
Yes, sir, most definitely.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't that stifle diversity a little bit?
That's possible.
There's something in the Constitution that says that the church and the state have to be kept separate.
There is no such language in the Constitution.
No, it's been misinterpreted, yeah.
Everyone in Congress and the president violates the Constitution more than they uphold it.
Really?
Yes.
Everyone in Congress?
No, yes, just, no.
No,
I don't qualify my statement. I said just about everyone in Congress violates the Constitution far more than they uphold it.
Undeterred by earthly laws, from Cartersville, Georgia to Tucson, Arizona, Cops for Christ continue to book suspects with the good book.
Now that I have advised you of the key to salvation, are you willing to give your life to Jesus Christ?